President Trump might not have helped his case when he tweeted out that incendiary and racially charged web ad just 2 days ago, an ad that attempts to stoke fears about undocumented immigrants. It cites the case of a Mexican man who killed two California sheriff's deputies, flashing two images of the migrant caravan while also showing images of the cop killer. It turns out that potentially offensive exterior is the gift wrapping around claims inside the ad that are just false. CNN's Tom Foreman dug into the argument underneath it all. And Tom, the ad suggests the Democrats are solely to blame for this cop killer's presence in the U.S. Is that true?
Yes, it does just that, Jake. And it's true that the ad says that, and then it utterly fails to prove it.
Using an actual court appearance by convicted cop killer Luis Bracamontes, the video gets this right. The Mexican man who entered the United States illegally did say he'd like to kill more police officers.
Break up soon, and I'll kill more.
But then it goes factually off the rails with two big claims. Democrats let him in, and Democrats let him stay. Both are misleading at best, at worst, flat out false. Here's why. Records indicate Bracamontes entered the U.S. illegally and was deported more than once before those murders. True, an Immigration and Customs official told CNN it occurred under Democrat Bill Clinton in 1997. But it happened again in 2001 when George W. Bush, a Republican, was in office. Sacramento Bee newspaper also found records indicating Bracamontes was back in the U.S. again in the early 2000s, still under President Bush. Bracamontes was arrested at least three times in Maricopa County, Arizona, on drug and weapons charges. That was the territory of then-Sheriff Joe Arpaio, an outspoken supporter of President Trump. So much so, Arpaio was even pardoned by the president when the sheriff's racial profiling of immigrants ran afoul of the courts. The Bee and other sources found Bracamontes was deported twice and once released in those cases. Arpaio's assessment?
I don't know how many times he was arrested and slipped through the cracks. It's my gut feeling that it wasn't just two times he's been deported.
Still, the video goes further, suggesting scores of other immigrants could be just as threatening. Homeland Security has even said the caravan approaching the border is harboring more than 200 folks with criminal histories, while offering precious little proof and few details.
So the Trump administration, through this video and statements, is strongly suggesting this caravan is filled with young men just as dangerous as Bracamontes, gang members, killers, drug dealers, while denying the overwhelming evidence of how many men, women, and children who come to the U.S. border seeking asylum are themselves fleeing poverty and violence in their home countries.